Okay, I got a few minutes. Thought I'd come in here and play around a little bit. Don't know how far I'll get. I'm kind of tired, lazy. But I thought I'd come back in and goof around a little bit. I have a hard time staying out of this stupid GNCD. But it's so fun. Try to shape up my fairway a little bit. Certain spots bug me. I tend to be way too much of a perfectionist the majority of the time. It's a disease, I tell you, it's a disease. But I have way too much fun doing it, so keeps me out of trouble. Try to keep my first cut of rough a little bit flatter. Doesn't have to be a perfect 0 degree angles. But I don't like to see that angle greater than 15 degrees, I guess, for me. Now, my one superintendent told me that their riding mowers can go probably safely like about 20-25 degrees before it gets in danger of tipping. Personally, I wouldn't want to ride it at that type of an angle, but you know, that's neither here nor there. That's just the way it is. Touching up a few of the high spots and low spots. Okay, now if I remember right, this was starting to look pretty good off the tee box. The angle was pretty high though, if I remember right. We were talking in the neighborhood of 78 feet up from the tee box. I like this area here. When I had started placing some of the rough, it lost some of its little luster. Try to flatten out some of this area a little bit. Don't want my fairway to run off into that steep area too much. My little phobia of having a semi-flat first cut. We've covered that enough in some of these videos. I think most have a good idea of what I anticipate for cut of rough. I'm sure I've made a few people angry with it, but that's just too bad. There's no written rule. But I think most tend to agree, at least in the top echelon of designers, that first cut of rough should be a little more less steep angled. I won't say flat. I'll just use less steep angled than some of the other hillier courses. Same thing when it comes to running into a bunker and what have you not. You'll find that most of the top designers do not have an inverted bowl or a steep light cut of rough running into a bunker. I do like some of the textured look that Highland Steam gives out. Yeah, see, that looks really good like that. I keep saying I want to do bunker up in here. I don't know if it's really necessary. See, I love that look. It's kind of unique. Gives it that waist area look. Like, be careful where you hit. God, I really wonder why I can't get it to line up. The default at the driver. Do so. So that's the typical landing area with the driver. That's what I found out with no headwinds. And then it's 2:45. So, to get it to line up there, let's do an experiment. It's really gonna affect the waypoint. This is gonna be one of those exceptions to my rules. About the waypoint should be in the middle of the fairway. Because it's a par 5, I do want the default alignment to bring you up into this area, to the middle. We already discovered that it's not going to be .265 off the tee because of the fact that you're hitting up almost 100 feet, about 33 yards. Let's see if it defaults out now. Still 245. What the heck? This is pretty crazy. I don't know why it's doing that. It's not the first time. Sometimes in order to get to your set par, you have to delete some stuff. I've been finding out that my distance markers create some of the problem. So let's just set this waypoint out here. You're not going to end up here, and the problem with this waypoint being up here is, let's say you do hit out here, your second shot's going to want to go to the first waypoint. You don't have multiple waypoints. So therefore, it does cause a difficult or a misleading second shot. But out of curiosity, see if this works. Nope. Unless I need to exit the game. Now let's see if that made any difference. Something's telling me it didn't. And if it didn't, I'm going to set the waypoint back to where it should have been in the first place. Okay, and it made zero difference. So for some reason, I don't understand why it's defaulting to a 3-wood and not the driver. Okay, that's not gonna let me do that, so we'll use my little delete trick here. And sure enough, I'll move my waypoint back to my original setting. Even though this is about where it should be, I'm afraid if I put it here, it's going to default me to a 5-wood. I do want to force the fade around the dog leg more than a straight hit up the hill. Too many straight hitters and not enough people that know how to create shots. Sometimes you have to do it in the game of golf. Same should be in the game here. Shouldn't force shot making capabilities without necessarily penalizing those who can't and just do the straight hits. I kind of like it to award the shot creators and don't give much to the straight hitters. Actually, I don't like the straight hitters all that much. And I try to also throw little curveballs on the math guys that always like to calculate out exactly their distance and how far they're gonna hit their clubs. Yeah, it's just too much. And I know that statement bothers people. But, you know, I don't really care. You don't sit on a real course and start doing the math. You use approximations, you do calculate, but again, it's an approximation, not an exact science. Whereas in this game, it seems like it's became an exact science and little guesstimation. You can see here, I'm trying to smooth out that first cut of row. It was a little bit too much of an angle for me. Trying to flatten it down a little bit. So this washboard effect too. I don't mind having a few waves, I just don't like the idea of thinking I'm surfing. It doesn't look quite so wavy. This bunker is going to be fun. It's actually almost too deep. How deep is it, you say? And here's one way of finding out how deep it is. Remember these little guys called distance lockers? I like to set it up there. set up on the edge of the game, you can see that it's like 10-foot, 11-foot deep bunker. The spot is 15 feet deep in the back. Pretty good size depth for a bunker. And what's it like to come out of? Play from there. Always test. 48 yards, 20 feet up. That's pretty good size. Yeah, it's going to be a fun little monster. Excuse me. Didn't have a heck of a lot of sleep. So as nasty as this bunker is, I'll raise it up a little bit. Take a little bit of a bite out of it. Levels. 15 feet. Take it up a little bit. There is no exact science on this. I don't want to mess with my load too much. I already have that leveled out. Now that's kind of crazy here. But now, if I was to drive along this road, I dang sure wouldn't want no golf balls bouncing off on my car that was driving by. So having a little bit of a ridge here to catch the ball. Bounced off and dinged at the car. Okay, so that doesn't look too bad. Again, most of this I do with a fuzzy brush, a little circular brush. My methodology is if it looks right, then it probably is right. Now the Depth isn't too bad. Well, a little bit of a lip. Not much. I could have come in with the flattening tool and it would have probably helped out a little bit. I just feel I have a little more control. Using the raise tool and then lowering or raising the lip the way I want it. There's a lot of different ways to go about doing your bunkers. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that bunker. Just raise the back of this one up a little bit. Good. And there still will be a lot of changes on that one later down the pipe. There's the green. I'm not exactly happy with it. I think it still has a little bit too much runoff. Here's my original pin position for day one. This will be like a day four pin position. I have yet to do everything I want to do with the screen. Further down the road. I think I'll do now is throw in a little bit of the sand bunker stuff just to see what it looks like. Before I do that, let me get a good save spot. Now this isn't necessarily going to be a giant bunker because I don't want to destroy the texture that the program has already created. I love the muddy effect or the dried up ground. So what I'm going to do is try to preserve as much of that as I can. And keep the natural look going. Now I'll probably flatten this down a little bit. Or raise this up, one or the other. The intent here is to accent the difference between the dried up mud look and keep some of the grasses that was already generated. Love this marbling effect. Once you start doing this, you're pretty committed because it's a lot of deletion otherwise. And when you're using small brushes to lay down your sand, I really wanted to do it right through here. I prefer to create my own shapes. There's times, like I was using this, what I call the dog shape. But I prefer to create your own bunkers. You can start off with one. But then try to modify it. This way it keeps it your design and not like everybody else's design where they all have the same bunker or the bunker style. Like I said, make it your own. Still haven't really decided what I want to do with this area here. It's it's more or less a punishment area for those that hit really long. But it really doesn't come into play. It's supposed to be more of an intimidation factor. These are more or less like a waste bunker type of deal. So being perfectly level or flat is not a mandatory. Just come through and give it a little bit of a depth. Little shaping. I like to have a little bit of undulation in a waste bunker because nothing's perfect. I want it perfectly flat. I want to have a visible light wave because, you know, you get stuck in a bunker, they get raked over. They're not exactly smooth. They're not perfectly groomed all the time. The only time you're going to see a perfectly groomed course is when you're the first one out in that morning after they've done all the work. From that point on, it's no longer perfect. For all those that really want to say, oh, it's got to be perfectly flat and that, well, I'm sorry. It doesn't work that way in real life, nor should it work in your design. You want little imperfections always. It looks too perfect, it's just, I don't know. Yeah, it's a pitch-perfect golf course in an unrealistic situation or environment, unless you're one of the first ones out. The bigger the sand trap, the more you're going to have wind variation flowing dirt and changing. So you want little pits and valleys. Now, this little thing is going to be a little different story. I'm going to use my flattening brush and try to flatten it down. I want it more consistent. Without losing my terrain too much. Not really too hungry, but sounds good. You can make it now and I'll eat it later, if that's okay. That's fine. Okay, let's see what I did to that. Always play and test, test, play, test. Keyboard P. I want to play the whole, press 2. Kind of an interesting little flyover. Still got to do a lot at the end. Seems like I lost some of my view. I liked the view before. I don't really get to pick up the trap. This has got to come down a little bit up here. And what I said about the club selection when I dropped it back, it defaulted to the 5-wood. Alright. So I really don't see my sand trap. I see these bushes back here. And I want more of my that visible. I'm going to get that to show off the ridge. I gotta do something I'm not really fond of doing here. Got a feeling this gonna take away from what I just did. Yeah, it took away a little bit. I want the whole trap to be visible. I just want it to be visible enough to let you know that it's there from the tee box. Yeah. And like I said, the minute I started raising it, I was going to lose some of my definition here. But I'm not losing a lot of it. That's why it's important to only raise in small increments. As you can see, I'm doing it in like 1 or 2 inches. And while it doesn't look like a large amount of elevation changes, it shows. Now I jump back to my little fuzzy brush. I don't know what you want to call it. That's what I call it, my fuzzy brush. Fine tune the elevation. I go with what looks good. When it gets the look I want, that's when it's correct. Kind of get an idea of what you want. Paying attention to all the little shadowing. No amount of detail is too small. It all plays its effect. This is one of those bunkers where I won't put any bordering around. I say that now. Although, well, think about it, maybe I'll just might do that. Let me see what that effect is. Usually I'll go with the heavy buff. I'm on a fuzzy brush like this. Let's see what that does. Give a little coloration. Yeah, that's not too bad. I can deal with this. Just a little bit of heavy rough around there. Accent the bunker a little bit. Without losing my grasses. This isn't really necessary, but it's one of those things that going one more step, one more detail that helps make that course pop just a little bit more. Again, it's the details. Always details. It's what makes the difference between a good course and a fantastic course. I can see that's kind of cool, because now I kind of highlighted that bunker a little bit. And seeing how I got a little shade, I'll just kind of bring it back into here a little bit. Same thing with over in here. I don't want to ruin much of my grass that's already been there, but I just want to throw a little more heavy rough in there. Just to give it a little more interesting look. And come in here and highlight it a little bit more. Just a little color. Without getting crazy. Now you can see a little more grass. Heavy grass, which is kind of cool. Like I said, it's all the details. It's always in the details. I can't stress that enough. You want something that looks good, spend a little time in doing it. Look at what you do. Get into your work. Don't just start clicking and plopping down stuff without thinking about it. There's a gazillion courses out there, and a lot of people, I guarantee, don't do this. You want your course to stand out, start doing the little details. Don't be like every other designer. Let's try to see how many courses you can pump out within 10 days. Spend the time, do your course, get involved, get down into it. Try to bring out the little accented areas like this so they pop that much more. See how that starts to look and shines in there a little bit more. It gives it that realistic look of terrain. You don't need all the fancy flowers and everything else. I mean, yeah, I did a course with flowers finally. There's time for it. Most of the time, your course is green, dried up green. Wish we had some fescue grass. But see what you can do. See, just by the little details. It's just a matter of a few clicks, and you get into seeing some heavy, rough grass growing in. Everything on this course so far, I haven't planted a single object except for some trees that I wanted to see. I did that way back in the earlier episode. And the whole reason I explained why I did this, I wanted to be able to come in and see what trees I had available to me and what they look like from start to finish. And I just lay them out. This way I get an idea of what they look like, shadowing and everything out, what their default height is. It's good. I'll come back and I'll delete those probably later. But that's the only time I've done any planning so far. I wanted an oceanfront. I haven't even started playing well with that idea. This will probably be like a cliff view. How do you do that, Dave? Well, let's see, dog. What do you do? Well, first thing I do is I get myself a tool. Go sculpting. I'll go with the raised tool. Then I grab... What's going on here? Uh-oh. I don't like what's happening. Someone hit escape. I'm really lagging. Hit escape. Wow. I don't know what happened. I'm still going to hit escape. I'm going to save this real quick. I don't like the little oops it was going on. I'm watching my counter up here. Alright. Saved. Go back in here and edit. Sculpt. Raise. Yeah, I usually grab one of my more interesting brushes. Depending on how rugged of a fairway I want. God, I want one with sharper edges. This one doesn't... It does good, but it doesn't give me the sharp, nasty edges I really want. I've done a lot with just brushes like these. It's still not quite rugged enough. This one's pretty good for doing that stuff. First things first, let's just chop some fairway. Whoa. Man. Really? How much does it take to get me down there? Okay, so when you go... to an extreme... Oh, crying out loud. This will give me a rugged coastline. Okay, so now I get down there, wow. I can go back to my flattening brush. Then I'll start running along. This will chop me down so I have a cliff. First important thing is get rid of my shoreline. The initial chopping away of the borderline It's not that important. I'm just trying to get my coastline going here. Kind of nibble away. You ever did any work with metal? You get one of those little nibblers and you just kind of take little tiny chunks off your metal to cut it away. Well, that's pretty much what I'm doing here. Be ready to always use the undo key. When you come close to the end of your border, keep in mind how that's going to look. I want to try to keep that shoreline look. In order to do that, it's going to be a little tricky. But what I will do is I will just kind of bring this out to a point and then I'll start flattening and smoothing it out. It's really sad that I can't like drop off a tanker out in the middle out here or something like that. You can't do that. You're kind of confined as to where you can plant your objects. Now, I come through and I try to lower my grain, get a little more smooth the brush. So what I have here is an issue. So we use trickery and deceit to make that borderline kind of fall into the natural look of the terrain without seeing the borderline. It's patience. And trial and error. But it usually always pays off if done right. On the edge of your so-called borderline, it's not real critical. Because you're never going to be over on that part of the map to worry about it. We're trying to create a visual from a distance, so perfection isn't a must. Especially if it's out of flyover zone. As you can see, I get that little kind of like beachfront area now. Like I said, don't ever be afraid to hit the undo button because you might click it one time too many and it messes up what you already achieved. It's always a fine line. I don't want this. That's why I'm undoing. Big problem with what has happened with one of the later updates is you can only undo so many times now. I believe it's like about 10 stages that you can go back, which kind of sucks.